Okay, recording this video Sunday, 5th of October 2014. Hope you're enjoying your weekend. Well, what a week's trading. Seems like the good old days to me. The market was putting in decent volumes. We had nice trending moves that kind of followed through. Seemed to be kind of smoother than we've had in the last several months. I must admit, the summer this year just seemed kind of really patchy. You know, the trending moves never kind of followed through very much. We kind of would get going and then have reversal days a lot. But, you know, the last several days we've had some really nice trading. So let's hope that continues. I want to talk about trending moves today, breakouts, and how to spot large breakout trades, because we've had some really nice moves this week, and I want to talk about Wednesday specifically. This is an email I got actually a couple of weeks ago, but I've been waiting for the right opportunity to kind of respond to this one from Greg. So let me read you this. Barry, is there anything you look at in real time to determine if a trend break is likely to be a good move or just an overshoot? Some of my thoughts, professional or amateur bars making the break, jumping the creek, falling through the ice, price level relative to the recent past, high or low on curve price, double or triple being broken. Thanks for all your excellent work and heart for helping others trade. So, Greg, there is something I look at, and it's to do with your point that you make about overshoots here. It's whether the trending move is going to be caught by the next highest time frame, and we're just going to get an overshoot or a decent trending move. So I'm going to try and explain this using Wednesday's trade, Wednesday the 1st of October, using three different time frames, the day trading time frames, the 500, 1500, and 4500 tip bar chart. And this is Wednesday's trade. Wednesday was set off by Tuesday. Tuesday was a reversal day. You can see here that we had a little bit of weakness first thing, and then we went into a strong uptrend move, ending up with exhaustion, buying, and bearish divergence, blue professional bars to the high. We just overshot this little resistance level and then turned away. The second half of the day was marked by a strong downtrend move, and then we closed on the lows. So that's a reversal day where we kind of go in an uptrend in one direction. You know, the first thing in the morning before 11 a.m. we get a reversal. Let's see where 11 a.m. is on this chart. Here we go. So 11 a.m. is kind of the window for reversal. As long as we've started to reverse by 11 a.m., that's kind of a good move. If we've not started a decent reversal by 11 a.m., it's unlikely we're going to have a proper reversal day. But this was a nice reversal day. And what you expect after a reversal day is a continuation of that move. The trending move has gone to the downside, and we expect continuation the next morning. The reason you expect a continuation is that a lot of the traders who are swing trading stocks or kind of amateurs and so on that are not day trading, they've not had the opportunity during the afternoon to see that the market reversed and went the other way to get out of their stocks. So they're looking at their charts at the end of the day in the evening and saying, whoops, you know, I need to get out of this, take profits, go short on something or whatever it is. And so the next morning, you'll have a whole bunch of kind of negative selling type activity that is a continuation of what was happening in the second half of that day. So that's because those people are putting in their trades, you know, before the open, ready for the open, shortly after the open, kind of getting this move going with a momentum continuation of what happened in the afternoon. So that's why I say look after a reversal day, expect continuation. And what I'm looking for is that move will end when we have exhaustion patterns during the full liquidity of the day. Now, what I mean by full liquidity of the day is during the day session, not after hours, not pre-open or anything like that. That's not good enough. If the professionals have got short during the day here, they're going to look for that type of volume to get out of their positions. And there's not enough volume during the after hours or the pre-open kind of session to get out. This exhaustion selling is just traders, you know, exiting at the end of the day or putting on those overnight trades kind of going on. That's not good enough. If we'd had any kind of exhaustion move during that overnight session, that wouldn't be good enough either. What I'm looking for is exhaustion during the full liquidity of the day. And this happens to be on this particular day, on that Wednesday, on the 4,500 tip bar chart. That's when the exhaustion came in, at the end of the day. So you can see this volume that was getting short here then made it out all the way to the end of that trending move kind of down here. Big move down to 19, kind of 35. So coming into Wednesday's open, we've got a short bias because we had a reversal and we expect momentum and continuation during the morning. And what we get is we get a whole bunch of blue professional bars first thing in the morning here, bang, bang, bang. Those are selling down. They're selling because we get nowhere near the highs. The highs don't get broken. They're down professional bars, but we continue down through the lows. So they've been selling this thing down. If they were down bars and then the highs got broken, then they were maybe buying that dip and getting in at a better price. But no, they're like anxious to sell down because we continue to break the lows and we continue to break down. And that blue professional bar through support is falling through the ice. So it's professionals selling down through support at that price point, kind of selling down. And this is what I'm looking for to spot big trending moves, big breakout moves. Remember, a breakdown is breaking through support into a downtrend. A break up is breaking through resistance on an uptrend move. But Wednesday was a down day, so I'm going to be showing you the principles on breaking of support levels. The same principles hold for breaking of resistance levels. So, first of all, where is the support level? The support level is 1958 and a quarter. Okay, so there's support level being broken on the 4500 tip bar chart. Now, I can put on my little marker on this chart, and that'll show exactly the same time print on the different charts kind of going forward. So here's the 500 tip bar chart, and I've cleaned this chart up a little bit. I've taken better pro am off the price bars. I've taken better momentum off the price bars. You got momentum below the lines here. You got on the price bars the trending moves and from better sine wave kind of printed. Here on this time frame, you can see we'd already broken down into a downtrend on the 500 tip bar chart, and the support level being broken there is 59 and a quarter. So on one chart it's 58 and a quarter, the other chart it is 59 and a quarter. So they're happening very close together. We're getting trending breaks on those two time frames. On the 1500 tip bar chart, you can see here's the support level that gets broken on the downside, and this one is at 56 and three quarters. So those three support levels are coming in pretty close together. One's at 56 and a quarter, one's 56 and three quarters, one's 58 and a quarter, one's 59 and a quarter. So we've all been within, you know, a couple of points or so. Now, because they're happening at the same time, at the same price point, kind of being broken down, that means that there's no support level that's going to come in later in this trend move to catch the trending move on the way down. So let me try and explain that. So we're breaking on the 500 tip bar chart, we're breaking down into a trending move here. On the 1500 tip bar chart, we're breaking into a trend move here. And on the 45, we've already broken into a trend move here. Now, if the support on the 4500 tip bar chart was coming in later, maybe down here, that would be catching a potential trend move on the way down. It would be an area of support, and it would mean that that trending move on the way down was not as strong because a higher time frame level, we were going to hit a support level at some point and bounce from there. And so that would be maybe an overshoot of a support level on the 1500 that didn't break into a proper trending move and just got caught by support on this time frame. But because the support has already come in on the higher time frame, it's not there to catch this move. We're in a trending move on this high time frame, and we're going to kind of play down until this thing is over with a pullback to end of trend. So look for the three support levels to come close together so that you'll get a strong trending move. It can't be caught by a higher time frame support level kind of coming in because it's already been broken. So that's the trick. Now, just a couple of points here. We then break into a nice kind of trending move with a pullback to end of trend move. That's pullback to end of trend. The signal there says end of trend. All that means is this trending move is over. It doesn't say bottom. It doesn't say that is the bottom for the day. It just means that means that trending move is over. And what we'll get after we get a trendy move is a little bit of cyclicality, a little bit of playing around in the range until we break into another trend move, whichever way it is, could be up or could be down. So the end of this trend, we then go into a little bit of cyclicality. We break between, we hit the support level, break back up to the resistance level, come back to a support level, and we break into another downtrend. Again, end of trend does not say bottom, happens to be the bottom for the day, but all we're going to do then after the end of trend is go through some cyclicality, and then the next day we break into another trending move on the way down. So just note that these are saying this is the end of a trending move, which then means we're going to have some cyclicality. We're just going to play around the ranges a little bit because the trend is over, but that does not say bottom. doesn't say bottom for the day is in. It just means that trending move is over. We'll have a little bit of a play, and then we'll figure out, are we going to break down, continue on down into a trending move, another trending move on the way down, are we going to break to the upside? Of course, on the 4500 tip bar chart, we know this is going to continue to break down until we see that exhaustion pattern. That's the key. You know, the move is not over until we see exhaustion pattern. Normally, I look here on the 1500 tip bar chart for those good kind of trending moves and the exhaustion patterns. But, you know, such a strong move on the 4500 tip bar chart, you know, that's where the exhaustion came at the end of the day. So, advice for today is spotting large trending breakout moves by looking for these support levels coming in simultaneously and being broken at the same time and kind of close together.
It's got short 59.75, short 59.75, checking stops and targets. And the reason for getting short yesterday was a down day. We had this kind of 78 kind of top, and then bang, crashed to the downside and broke new lows. And we're now sitting, just got to be careful, we're sitting at this kind of 1960 level. It's absolutely key. On the 40,500 tip bar chart, you can see we're in this channel, bang, bang, bang. A lot of blue professional bars yesterday on the 40,500, and that's very unusual. Usually at one or two, we got five. And one at the highs, 78, that's important. And this whole cluster sitting above 60. So now we're breaking the lows of those and through the support on 40,500. So it could be a big kind of break to the downside because 60 gives way and then it's all over. So we're just bouncing off a support. I was just kind of chasing, running into this a little bit. But resistance is in here. We've got to run down. And two blue professional bars, one down bar. The one at the open, I'm not too worried about, but this one kind of down. We want to see an exhaustion pattern during today's session. So following on from, you know, the sell down into the close yesterday, we'd see another one kind of moving down. So no blue professional bars here, just one there. All right, let's want this support to break, get us into a trend move, minus 5,000 here. Yeah, it could be a little bit early, could be, you know, just testing up and then kind of coming down, but let's see. All right, we're just crashing through support now, so it's running into a proper trending move on the way down on 500. Target's at 55.75. So, still a few points away. I'm just going to leave it there for the time being, but now we've broken 60 properly, so in terms of areas that we've found support before, what's this low overnight? 7.75. So we could be having a technical bounce at that area. Here we go, so we just hit it. So all these blue professional down bars could be falling through the ice, through that support on 4,500, take us into a strong downtrend. All right, move my target out to 53.75. Quite a ways away, but we're breaking down through the support on 15. This blue professional bar came in on the retrace. It wasn't on the way down, it was actually on the retrace. Just broken below. We still got to go pull back into trend on the 500 tip bar chart. Getting all kinds of extreme readings here. We've got 6,000. This has got to go pull back into trend. Blue professional bar on the retrace, not on the way down. So let's see that one broken to the downside, and that means they were getting in on that retrace. Yep, there we go. Alright, so it's a triple. We got support going on these three time frames, so it's a big move. We're coming up the original target for 575. And yeah, that's about to be hit. So 6,000. As soon as you see the blue freshman bar starting to come in, excellent. Go, just take it out. 53.75. Unbelievably quick there. It just fell away. 4-6. And it's actually coming in with pro signal exit. I don't know. It's going to be a big down day. We've got pullback to end of trend on the 500 tip bar chart. Maybe I should have moved it out further, but it is what it is. I'm happy with that. Was at 8:39 a.m. And it's before the PMI number comes out or anything like that. Yeah, it's collapsing. Excellent.